I'm a New Yorker. As a teenager, I watched the Twin Towers being built. In the tough economic times of the late 70s, I strolled the World Trade Center food court and underground shopping mall on my way to sign for an unemployment check. I've covered news conferences in Windows on the World, the restaurant at the top of the North Tower. It was hard to believe such enormous, solid, seemingly permanent buildings could collapse. To this day, I feel their absence when I approach the city from Brooklyn or New Jersey. Poet Nany Mercado, a fellow New Yorker, felt compelled to write about what she lost when the towers came down.
Going to work. On their daily trips, commuters shed tears now, use American flags like veiled women to hide their sorrows, rush to buy throwaway cameras to capture your twin ghost. Frantically, I too purchase your memory on postcards and coffee mugs in New York City souvenir shops, afraid I'll forget your facade, forget my hollowed Sunday morning PATH train rides, my subway travels through the center of your belly day after day, afraid I'll forget your powers to transform helicopters into ladybugs gliding in the air, to turn New York City into a breathing map, to display the curvature of our world.